Namaste. Come with me to Curdi village in South Goa that emerges only once a year just before the monsoons. Before we reached Curdi, we saw these small shivalingas in the village where the villagers of Curdi have relocated. We drove through the dirt roads in search of the submerged village that emerges sometime in May, just before the monsoon season. The water levels of Salaulim Dam are lowest at this time of the year, and some ruins that have managed to survive the pressure of water for more than 30 years make an appearance. As we drove around the water bodies, we saw the stubs of coconut trees still managing to stand. They look like ghosts from the past. Look at the green tree line behind the water. It indicates the water level of the dam. Everything below that level goes underwater once the monsoon sets in. As we drove further, ruins slowly started making an appearance. Soon, we found ourselves standing in the middle of a ghost town that was living just about 35 years ago. The moist ground all around was still trying to get dry. Will it manage to get a dry spell? Who knows? Standing on the ruins of this house, I could see the layout of a village all around me, with some Tulsi Vrindavans managing to survive and stand tall. Some ruins here, some ruins there, and a village that was living just a few years ago. We drove further towards the Someshwar Mahadev temple, which is still a living temple. Its original Shivalinga still stays inside the sanctum of the temple, and the villagers still come here every May to visit their deity. The signs of the just held Curdi Jatra were all over the place. The temple has a photograph of the original temple, and you can see that it is only the sanctum part that remains now. The temple almost submerges in the water post-monsoons. A typical Goan-style Deepastambh still manages to stand. Then next to it, there is Shezo, which is like a green room standing between the temple and the stage that used to be used for performances right next to the Kushavati River. Next to the temple, there are big and small ruins of houses, of a stage, a well-maintained well, Tulsi Vrindavans, and a path leading to the temple. Somewhere here lived the famous singer Mogubai Kordikar, mother of Kishori Amonkar, who came from this village. Imagine life on the banks of a pristine river like Kushavati. Next to the river, the scenery is breathtakingly beautiful, with hilltops reflecting in the water. Curdi is hauntingly beautiful.
पिछले महीने क्या रहा होगा यहाँ पर?
थोड़ा इससे ऊंचा लेवल ऑफ वाटर, slightly ऊंचा.
It was time to say goodbye to Curdi. I do not know if I will get to visit it again, but it will stay etched in my memory forever. It is a ghost town in making, something that is taking, or should I say losing, shape in our lifetimes. Future generations may not see these ruins, at least not in the shape and form I have seen it today. If you enjoyed this video, or if you have a question, do leave us a comment, and do not forget to subscribe IndiTales YouTube channel. Thank you very much.